Have heard all the horror stories about beginner sellers not being able to sell on Amazon and getting rejected, and you don't simply want the same to happen to you? Well, by the end of this video, I'll share with you enough information that the same does not happen to you, so be sure that you stay tuned. So a very common issue among beginner Amazon sellers is not even having the opportunity to sell on Amazon. I know several of people that I personally know have either had their applications delayed for weeks, if not months, or just simply never were able to even sell on Amazon. So in this video, I'm actually gonna share with you a solution on, you know, kind of how to help you really, first of all, never get to that position where you are fighting Amazon to open an Amazon account. And number two, avoid it from the beginning altogether. Now, if this is your first time to this video, please be sure to subscribe. Also, consider sharing this video with a friend of yours and comment below BJKU to get the chance to win our weekly giveaway. And by the way, last week's giveaway is Mrs. Gomez. Ms. Gomez, I don't know what your first name is, but be sure to reach out to us so you can claim your prize from last week. Now, starting right around January or February of 2020, I started receiving several messages from people that I know either in my programs or colleagues of mine or just people that have been following me on social media for a while saying that Amazon is giving them problems with signing up on Amazon, you know, creating a seller central account. And when I started looking into the emails correspondence from Amazon, it was simply the same exact email coming from all of the, you know, all the different clients or all the different people. And it was simply Amazon telling them that their privileges are either, they would either sign up and in like 24, 48 hours, they would get shut down or simply wouldn't be able to sign up. And then what Amazon's issue was, number one, either could not get verified. And although that these people were submitting all the information that Amazon was offering, or I mean the Amazon was asking for, or number two, they kept on saying that this account is associated with another account that you might have had. Because as you know, that as an Amazon seller, you're only supposed to have one account. You are able to get into partnerships with other sellers and open a second account if it is under their name. If it's gonna be under your name, you want to reach out to Amazon support and ask them and make sure that they're okay. So before I go too much in depth, let me explain to you the whole terms of service, or what terms of service actually has to say about this specific issue. So as an Amazon seller, you're only supposed to have one account, and they do that simply because they want to limit the amount, not the amount of sellers, but they want, because really to them it's an extra $40, but to them, they don't want, you know, people committing fraud under multiple accounts, or simply, you know, you open one account and then you sell a bunch of things that are, you know, fraudulent, or some products that are fake or bad quality, and then you don't care because you have all these other accounts. So they try to restrict you under one account, and that's okay, because you could actually have multiple brands, multiple products, different niches under one account, and doesn't matter. Now, in my case, I started needing other accounts because I started going into partnerships. So let's say I have my own account, and then let's say me and partner A are gonna go into company A, and then me and partner B wanna go in company B. So now I've got three different accounts, or I need three different accounts, right? So simply what we would do is we would create an entity, an LLC, and then we would be equal partners in the LLC, and then we would put it under my colleague's or my partner's name, and then we would apply under their name, right? Now, the thing about that is that a couple of things that Amazon looks for is, number one, the name and address cannot be the same. So you applied under your own account, let's say, and simply the new account cannot have the same address. The new business cannot have the same address that's similar anywhere else in the platform, okay? So that's the thing that you have to think about if you are gonna go and open a second account, is bring in a second partner, open an entity, and then open the account under the entity's name, and then put the partner's information. Make sure the entity does not have your information. Now, one thing you do have to understand is the entity information needs to match exactly what you're going to be applying for Amazon, and that's where the issue happens. So there are two issues. If you have an existing Amazon account, you open a second account, make sure nothing matches, right? Your current account address does not match. Banking information does not match. Your name is nowhere near that entity, okay? Because Amazon can tie it up. That's the number one case. The second case is if this is your first Amazon account and you are trying to open an account and you're just not able to,
What you need to do is, before you even get in trouble with Amazon, everything you need to apply needs to be under one name, same spelling, same everything. That's from the bank information, that's from the address, on your ID, on your bank, under whatever you're going to submit to Amazon. You also need to have a credit card, and that needs to be under a bank that has the same exact information. So your billing address cannot be different from your home address and your business address. Everything needs to be the same. Another thing, and very important, and I need you guys to really tune into this, because when you apply and Amazon asks for a, like a bill or a utility bill or something to confirm that you do reside in that address or your business does, you know, conduct business from that address, you need to submit a PDF file of a utility bill that has to do with that physical address. And what I'm talking about is like a gas and electric, water bill, okay? Cable, those will work. Now, if you have Verizon and then your Verizon bill comes to that home, that's not gonna work because that cell phone could be for anyone else, right? My friend could have their billing coming here, right? They live in a different state, or they just moved and they don't have a billing address. They could have my billing address. Doesn't mean that person lives here. So the utility bill that you provide needs to be congruent with that physical address. And as I mentioned, everything has to be the same, okay? Now, another thing that you guys have to think about is, if you're having problems with Amazon, or let's say if you have another person within the same household of you have an account and you want to open a second account, although that they are able to probably get another address, and that's the third point, get another address somewhere else, what you need to do is you need to make sure that their IP address that they're going to be applying for an Amazon account is completely different than the IP address that you're using. What I personally use is a company called VPN. I think it's called NordVPN or something like that. So what a VPN does is it simply gives you the ability to show that your IP address is somewhere else, not in the same physical location. And that's something that we are trying, you know, lately, and it's been working. Oftentimes what happens is when you open your buyer's account, somehow maybe you got an email, Amazon inviting you, and you somehow opened the seller's account without you even knowing it. And this happens so many times with our students, where they open an account without them even knowing it, and then at a later date they try to become sellers, and when they go to open a second account, thinking that it's their first account, Amazon connects the two, and then they just simply take away their privileges or never allow them to open a seller's account. And then they keep telling them that it is associated with another account, and they're just left confused, like, what are you talking about? I've never sold on Amazon, right? So then what you would need to do is you would need to maybe find another person, like your wife, your daughter, whatever. But do understand their address needs to be completely different. So maybe, you know, maybe your ex-wife or ex-husband, or maybe a child of yours that lives abroad, right? You simply use their information and you could open an Amazon account. But most importantly, when you're opening your first, very first, once again, this is not a hack. This is not, I don't know if it's against DOS or not. It probably is. You only are going to have to go that route if you are having the issues of Amazon, taking away your privileges, because they're saying that it's associated with another Amazon account. But as a beginner that you've never sold, you know for sure, for certain, you've never sold on Amazon, the number one most important thing that you have to make sure that you pay attention to is the information you're gonna be submitting to Amazon. If you're gonna start as a sole proprietor, if you're gonna start as an entity, even if it's just you, what you need to make sure of, a bank account. And that bank needs to be in operation for at least 30 days, because that's the only time when a bank will allow it to generate a statement, right? And that's what Amazon is gonna require. And do understand, the bank needs to match the business address, and it needs to match all the numbers and all the names. Everything needs to be exactly the same. However, if you're going to apply under your own name, under your own sole proprietor, then make sure that the address you're going to provide to Amazon is going to be the same address on your ID, the same address on the utility bills. The utility bill that you need to apply or submit to Amazon needs to be, you know, that has to do with physically with that physical address, like a, as I mentioned earlier, like a water bill, a gas and electric, you know, like your dish or your network or your TV network or whatnot, that has to do with that specific location. Outside of that, guys, I do really hope that you guys enjoyed this video and you found value. If you did, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Also, give this video a thumbs up. Now, if you're like Bashar, I love what you talk about and all of your videos are great, but I really want someone of, you know, that knows what they're talking about. Guide me through the entire process. Show me how the entire thing is done. What I've done is that I've put together a 25-minute free workshop where I simply break down to you exactly how selling on Amazon works step by step and show you what we do. And if you want to ask more questions and or if you want to find out how working with us directly looks like, at the end of that workshop, I prompt you to schedule a one-on-one call with either I or one of my team members where we simply walk you through the steps, answer your questions, and see how working together looks like. To do that, the first link in the description will take you to that workshop. Start there. Outside of that, guys, Bashar Kattu here. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have yourselves a great day. Take care.